Hi everyone, today I have another Topic Tuesday video for you, and today's topic is first indie polish you ever purchased and do you still own it? So my first indie purchase was several years ago and I can't remember which polishes I bought first, so I'm going to show you both. I still own them obviously since I'm going to show them to you, but I'm just not sure which one I bought first. I want to say it's these ones here. So I'm gonna show you these first. These are from a brand called Jindy Nails. She's no longer making polish. She stopped making polish several years ago. I'm not sure why. But this is called Chomp Chomp. And it is a matte red and matte blue glitter polish. So this was supposed to be the colors of, I believe, the Florida Gators football team or something. I'm not a Florida Gators fan. I just bought it because I thought it was a cool glitter. I will put swatches of all of these polishes on this video so you can see them. And this was super cute. I loved matte glitters when they first came out. This was one of the first matte glitter polishes I bought. And I just thought it was a really cute look, so I went ahead and got it. There is like circle glitter, square glitter, and bar glitter in here. It was just really interesting. It caught my eye. She used to sell on Etsy and then she got her own website. And then, like I say, she hasn't made polish for several years. I'm not sure what happened to her, but it's too bad because she had some really great polish. And then the other polish I purchased from her was called Frankenstein Spit. And I don't know if you all remember when these like micro glitters were in. There was a polish called Floam, I believe that's what it was called, that came out, and it kind of looked like when your TV would go to static, like that weird, like, I don't know, like on the TV, but in glitter. And this is similar to that, but in Halloween colors. So this was a Halloween polish, and it has matte fluorescent green, matte purple, and matte black. I've worn this a couple of Halloweens. I really do love the look this polish gives, and I usually wear it over white so that it stands out. So this is the other polish I picked up from her. And then the last polish that I got in that first order from her is called Happy Dance, and this is basically a white crelly with like matte coral glitter. There's turquoise shiny glitter, and then like some, I want to say like silvery iridescent glitters in here. I am a sucker for these white crellies, you guys. I've worn this polish before. It has a great formula. And I have a couple of other of these like white crelly base polishes from her, but I know these came from my first order because her label was like this, and then she did change it later on. I don't even know how old these are. They're probably, I'm gonna say, at least 6 or 7 years old. I bought these when I first got into polish. And then I'm pretty sure those came first, but the other one of the first indies I ever bought was from Lush Lacquer Salt and Pepper. This polish is amazing, you guys. I've mentioned this in one of my other videos. It's a matte white and black glitter polish. It has square glitter, circle glitter, bar glitter, and then there's also hologram glitter in here. So this was a dupe of Linderella's Connect the Dots polish. That was huge when I first got into polish. Everybody was posting swatches of that. Everybody was talking about it. Everybody wanted it. It was really expensive though. Linderella's were super expensive at that time, and they were like really hard to get your hands on. So when I found this dupe and it did have the addition of the holo glitter, I decided to pick it up. They're no longer called Lush Lacquer. I believe they're called Polish Me Silly now, and they still have an Etsy shop. I don't have any other polishes from them, but there you can kind of see the holo glitters. I do enjoy this polish. I've used it several times. It looks great over a ton of polishes. It's very versatile. I love it over like pastels in the spring, and it kind of gives you that like candy egg look where it's like the minty colored, like the pastel color egg, and then it has like the splotches. I don't know what that candy's called, but in spring I like to do that. In summer I like to put this over neon polishes and it just looks cool. Like, and then sometimes I'll do like a gradient stamp and I'll put this glitter over it. I've worn this, like I say, a bunch of times. It's very, very versatile. If you do not have a black and white matte glitter like this, you should look into one. It just like makes any plain cream you put on look super interesting. Every time I wear it, people are like, "Oh, what's on your nails?" And I have really enjoyed this polish. So those are the first indies I have ever purchased, and I hope you all enjoyed seeing them. Thank you for watching another Topic Tuesday video. If you like this video, please make sure to press the like button below. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please do, and I hope you all have a great day. Thanks for watching.